الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله، عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وقال تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال تعالى أيضا: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. صدق الله العظيم. As always, we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector and curer. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower his choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. O children of Adam, first and foremost, I enjoin upon myself and then all of you all who are present to adopt a life of taqwa, and that is to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be conscious of Him during every single second of our lives if we wish to attain success in this world as well as the hereafter. May Allah the Almighty make us all from the people of taqwa. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, to proceed, the title for today's khutbah is Stay at Home as Much as Possible. I know it may sound a strange topic, it is a topic that is not talked about, but bear in mind that this piece of advice is not from my pocket, but rather it is one of the three golden advices of our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May my mother, my father and myself be ransom for him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Uqba ibn Amir radiyallahu an goes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The hadith that I am about to mention is the hadith that talks about these three golden advices of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And insha'Allah ta'ala, today's khutbah will evolve around this beautiful hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The hadith is recorded in Tirmidhi. Uqba ibn Amir radiyallahu an goes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asks, Ya Rasulullah, man najah? Ya Rasulullah, please tell me how to attain salvation, how to attain victory, how to attain success in this world as well as the hereafter. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then teaches Uqba ibn Amir radiyallahu an and all of us, the whole ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, three golden advices. And insha'Allah ta'ala, we will try to briefly touch on each golden advice of our beloved master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first advice Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches Uqba ibn Amir radiyallahu anhu is Amlik alayka lisanak. Amlik alayka lisanak. The second advice, Wal yasa'ka baytuk. And the third advice, وَبِكِ عَلَىٰ خَطِيئَتِكَ. Three advices. Let me repeat the words of our beloved Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَمْلِكْ عَلَيْكَ لِسَانَكَ وَلْيَسَعْكَ بَيْتُكَ وَبْكِي عَلَى خَطِيئَتِكَ. These are the three beautiful advisors of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now let us take the first advice. أَمْلِكْ عَلَيْكَ لِسَانَكَ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is talking about apart from the parts of our bodies, a part which every single morning, every limb in our bodies, every single limb worn that particular limb. All of our limbs get together and warn that part of our body saying, fear Allah, fear Allah. All of our limbs, our hands, our legs, our eyes, our ears, all of our limbs warn that particular limb, fear Allah. And that limb, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, it is a small part of our body, but it has the strength, to make a man or to break a man. That part of our body has the strength to make a man or to break a man. It is a limb through which many people are in pits of misery because they have misused that part of their body. It is a limb which drives a wedge between two spouses. It is a limb which causes a revolution. It is a limb which causes enmity and hatred towards two friends. It is a limb which has the potential to break a partnership perhaps. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us, control your tongue. أَمْلِكْ عَلَيْكَ لِسَانَكَ. Keep your tongue at bay. Control your tongue. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, if each and every one of us were to analyze, just as the genius Umar radiallahu anhu says, حَسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُوا. Take account of yourselves before you are taken into account. Audit your books before your books will be audited for you. If we were to analyze our day-to-day lives, for example, if we were to sit down at night just before we sleep and think of the words we have spoken throughout the day. Nay, now you're seated in Jummah. Think from morning till now, how many words have I uttered? And from those words, how many of those words are pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And how many of those words are displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How many of those words have been against my own brother in Islam? How many of these words? Psychologists mention that on an average day, a male, he speaks 10,000 words. He utters 10,000 words. And on the other hand, women, they utter 20,000 words, double the number of men. 10,000 words, on an average basis, we utter 10,000 words. So from these words, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, how many of them are pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Our salafuna salih, our pious predecessors, they used to make note of each and every word they spoke, some of them. So look at what an amount of control they had over their speech, over their tongue. They were following the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was once asked in regard to what would enter the bulk of mankind into Jahannam. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all from the blazing inferno of Jahannam. Ameen. What would enter the bulk of mankind into Jahannam? Once again, the hadith is in Tirmidhi. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replies, Al-Fam wal-Farj. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that the private parts of an individual and his tongue, these are the two limbs that would be the cause of the destruction of that individual, that would result in him being flung into Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. Allah the Almighty says in the noble Quran, مَا يَلْفِظُ مِن قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Man does not utter even a single word, even one single word, except that there is with him a vigilant observer. There is a vigilant angel making note of every single word of ours, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, and the hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. He who believes in the last day, he who believes in Allah the Almighty and the last day, let him speak good. Let him speak good or let him keep quiet. If he does not have any good to share, if he does not have good to say, then let him keep quiet, for that silence is better for him than him speaking evil speech. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, just as how we have a worldly life in today's modern era, we also lead lives on the World Wide Web. We have lives that we lead on these social platforms. We keep in touch with people online. So just as how it is important that we keep our tongue at bay in real life, it is important that we keep our texting and our messaging and our typing too in accordance. If we have something good to say, yes, then we share it, or else we keep quiet. Because today we have many individuals who enjoy juicy bits of gossip. They try to indulge in gossip, resulting in talking bad about people, resulting in them trying to dishonor people. At times, even in regard to deen, they talk evil about scholars. Allah save us all. And even online, they become trolls. You know, a troll is a person who deliberately puts up inflammatory statements in a particular thread or a particular forum or in a particular WhatsApp group, if you will, to try and cause as much as disruption, much as enmity in that group. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. If we have something good to share, then we go ahead and share it. But if not, we keep quiet in accordance to the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? There were even some of our Salafun as-Salih who learned silence by placing rocks in their mouth. They used to place rocks in their mouth, and whenever they thought of speaking something, they used to think, is what I'm going to say going to benefit me in this world or the hereafter at least? Is it something good? Is it something good? And if it wasn't, they used to gnash their tongue with that rock. They used to gnash their tongue with that rock so as to learn silence, to act upon the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, it is upon us too to follow the teachings of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and keep our tongues at bay. For by doing that, we save ourselves from a lot of evil. We save ourselves. We become respected individuals. And likewise, we stand a chance to attain success in this world as well as the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the successful ones. We move on to the next piece of advice. The second golden advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلْيَسَعْكَ بَيْتُكَ. Now this statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, scholars have given various translations, but at the end of the day, all of them point out to the same meaning, more or less. وَلْيَسَعْكَ بَيْتُكَ. Be content with your home. Stay at home. Give importance to your home. All of these meanings are included in that statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For our homes, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, our homes are the building blocks towards a good society tomorrow. But most of us, we have forgotten our homes. And even if we were to take the meaning, stay at home, and like I have titled the khutbah, stay at home as much as possible. By staying at home, we give time to our wives, we give time to our children, those who deserve our time the most. We nurture our children to becoming good human beings, to become good Muslims. And as Abu Darda radiallahu anhu is also reported to have said, the best place for worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely, in solitude, In secret is at one's home. So make your place of worship at home. Other than the salawat that you have to make in the masjid with the congregation, jama'ah, your optional salawat, you make it at home sincerely in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For if an individual remains at home, his tongue is safe from evil. His private parts are safe from evil. And his gaze is lowered. His gaze does not fall upon that which is haram. But sadly today, we find many of the youngsters too, spending late nights outside and coming home very late. If you were to talk on it on a more personal note, the more we are at home, the less we are to commit sin. The less we are going to commit sin. But if we spend time out, the traps of shaitan are far and wide. The traps of shaitan are far and wide. And we may fall in one of those traps. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. And also we live in a time where the fitna is coming down like rain. We live in a time full of trials and calamities. So it is always best to stay at home than indulge or fall prey for those trials and calamities. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. This is the second advice of our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever he used to make ablution, there are reports to state that he used to make this dua: Allahumma ighfir li dhanbi wa wassi' li fi dari wa barik li fi rizqi. Ya Allah, forgive my sins. Wa wassi' li fi dari. The same words as in the above hadith. وَوَسِّعْ لِي فِي دَارِي. Make me content with my home, or make me happy with my home. وَبَارِكْ لِي فِي رِزْكِي. And bless me in my provision, in that which you have provided me. So all of these narrations, and likewise this particular dua, teaches us that it is important that we take refuge in the safety of our homes during times where the trials and fitan are widespread. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. And it has also been mentioned in another hadith, which is in Muslim, where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that there, along the lines of these words, that there is not a believer who enters his home, he enters his home with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, saying Bismillah, and he enters his home, except that Shaitan, he cries out, he informs his troops, he informs the other shayateen that you do not have lodging in this particular house today. Because that slave of Allah entered his home with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So today you do not have lodging in this particular house. On the other hand, if we were to enter our homes not mentioning the name of Allah, we are giving shaitan and his armies, shaitan and his troops, free lodging in our homes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. And also the hadith goes on to say that when this believer, after he enters home, when he partakes of his food, if he says Bismillah, if he partakes of his food with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the devil cries out again to his troop, saying, all go out, you leave this home, because there is no food nor lodging for you in this house. So let us do everything with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we enter our homes with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah the Almighty will protect us from the evil of shaitan and from the harms of shaitan. We swiftly move on to the final advice of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that is wabki ala khati'atik. Allahu akbar. Wabki ala khati'atik. Take account of yourselves and cry over your mistakes, cry over your faults, cry over your sins. Allah the Almighty says in the noble Quran, الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down the best statement. Allahu nazzala ahsan al-hadith. Allah the Almighty has sent down the best statement, a book, i.e. the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Its parts resemble each other in goodness and in truth, and they are often repeated. Goosebumps travel down the skins of those who fear their Lord. Goosebumps travel down the skins of those who fear their Lord, and afterwards their skins and their hearts soften towards the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. But sadly, most of us, myself included, we find it difficult to cry in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, leave alone crying over our mistakes. We even find it difficult to cry when we hear the words of our beloved Maker. The result is, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, the result is because our hearts have hardened. Our hearts have hardened. Sins have blackened out our hearts. The darkness of sins have enveloped our hearts. Allahu Akbar. My beloved Shaykh, Imam Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, who was also known as the specialist of the heart, he says, إِذَا غُرِسَتْ شَجَرَةُ الْمَحَبَّةِ فِي الْقَلْبِ وَسُقِيَتْ بِمَاءِ الْإِخْلَاصِ وَمُتَابَعَةِ الْحَبِيبِ. If the tree of love for Allah and His beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is planted in an individual's heart, وَسُقِيَتْ بِمَاءِ الْإِخْلَاصِ, and if that beautiful tree is watered with the pure waters of ikhlas, athmarat with ikhlas and the following of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if that tree is watered with the water of ikhlas and the sunnah of our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, athmarat anwa' al-thimar, that tree would start giving fruits. That tree would start giving a variety of fruits, and the roots of that tree will be grounded firmly in that individual's heart, and the branches of that tree would grow to reach Sidratul Muntaha. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Beautiful statement of Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, like I said, it is because of the evil of the sins that we commit, our hearts have become dark, our hearts have become hard, our hearts have become enveloped in that darkness, so much to the extent that tears no longer flow. It is due to the hardness of our hearts. It is due to the hardness of our hearts. And the only way we can soften our hearts is through tawbah, turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then contemplating on the words of our powerful Maker. The more we ponder on the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more the greatness of the Creator we are subject to will fill our heart. The more we ponder and reflect on the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah the Almighty, He says in the Noble Quran, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Do they not ponder on the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Quran? أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Or are there locks on their hearts? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look at the choice of His words. He did not say, أَفَلَا يَسْمَعُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Do they not hear the Quran? أَفَلَا يَقْرَؤُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Do they not read the Quran? Do they not recite the Quran? Nay, our powerful Maker, He said, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Do they not ponder and reflect on the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because the more we ponder, the more we reflect on the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would fill our hearts. The more taqwa would enter our hearts, and our hearts would soften towards the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the Almighty says in the Noble Quran,
الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لا إله إلا هو. There is no other God worthy of worship other than Him. Al-Hay, the ever-living, the eternal. Al-Qayyum, the one who sustains all of what you see around you. The whole creation is being sustained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. Neither does a deep sleep or a tiny slumber, a tiny nap, ever overtake Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hadith is in Muslim. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu narrates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, Inna Allah la yanam, wa la yanbaghi lahu an yanam, yakhfidhu al-qista wa yarfa'u, yurfa'u ilayhi amalu al-layli qabla amali al-nahar, wa amali al-nahari qabla amali al-layl. Indeed, Allah the Almighty does not sleep, وَلَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُ أَنْ يَنَامُ, nor does it befit His Majesty, His glory, for Him to sleep. It does not befit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَخْفِضُ الْقِسْطَ وَيَرْفَعُ, He raises the scales of things and then lowers it. يُرْفَعُ إِلَيْهِ عَمَلُ اللَّيْلِ قَبْلَ عَمَلِ النَّهَارِ, the deeds of the night are raised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before the deeds of the day. And then the deeds of the day are raised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before the deeds of the night. حِجَابُهُ النُّور. الله أكبر. حِجَابُهُ النُّور. The veil of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is made of light. الله نور السماوات والأرض. Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth. حِجَابُهُ النُّور, His veil is made of light. لَوْ كَشَفَهُ لَأَحْرَقَتْ سُبْحَاتُ وَجِهِهِ مَنْ تَهَى إِلَيْهِ بَصَرُهُ مِنْ خَلْقِهِ. If Allah the Almighty were to move that veil of His, if He were to remove that veil, لَأَحْرَقَتْ سُبْحَاتُ وَجِهِهِ مَنْ تَهَى إِلَيْهِ بَصَرُهُ مِنْ خَلْقِهِ. The light from the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would burn every single creation in the path of the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, that would result in every single creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala burning to ashes, because nothing is hidden from the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing. Nothing is hidden from the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah the Almighty were to remove His veil, the light of His face would burn every single creation of His. Nothing would remain except Allah the Almighty. Hadith is in Muslim. It is an authentic hadith. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, all of these are hadith of our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Likewise, the ayat from the Noble Quran should fill our hearts with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should understand the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look around you, look at yourself. You yourself, you are a living manifestation of the proof of the greatness of our Creator. Look at creations like Jibreel alayhi salatu wassalam, an angel according to the ahadith with 600 wings. With 600 wings, each wing covers the horizon. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that once when he saw Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam, he had 600 wings and there were multicolored rubies, gems and jewels cascading from the wings of Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. What a great creation, what a great creature from the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then just imagine how powerful and how great that creator who we are subject to is. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. I mentioned one final hadith and I wrap up the khutbah. Hadith is in Tirmidhi. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, Inni ara ma la taraun. Inni ara ma la taraun. It is an amazing hadith, a hadith that should make our hearts tremble. It is a hadith that should make our eyes tear. Inni ara ma la taraun wa asma'u ma la tasma'un. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is informing us, Inni ara ma la taraun, I see what you do not see. Inni asma'u ma la tasma', I hear what you do not hear. Because of course, these are things that were taught to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not to say that Rasulullah was alimul ghaib. Nay, these are things that were taught to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He goes on to say, أَطَّتِ السَّمَاءُ أَطَّتِ السَّمَاءُ وَحُقَّ لَهَا أَن تَئِطْ. The heavens are creaking. The heavens are squeaking. The heavens are creaking and the heavens deserve to creak. The heavens are creaking and the heavens deserve to creak. مَا فِيهَا مَوْضِعُ أَرْبَعِ أَصَابِعُ. There is not even space for four fingers. There is not even space for four fingers. Illa wa malakun wadi'un jabhatahu sajida. Allahu Akbar. Except that there is an angel in prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is not even space for four fingers, for you to place four fingers, except that the heavens are full of angels, full of malaika, making sajda to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes on to say, Wallahi, law ta'lamuna ma a'lam. Wallahi, by Allah, if you knew what I know, Allahu Akbar, if you knew what I know, لَضَحِكْتُمْ قَلِيلًا وَلَبَكَيْتُمْ كَثِيرًا. You would laugh less and you would cry more. You would laugh very little and you would cry more. The hadith goes along the lines of these words. If you knew what I know, you would laugh less and you would cry more. You would leave your women, folk who are on the bed. You would leave seeking pleasure from your women. You would go out into the open plains seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, these three golden advices of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam should fill our hearts with taqwa so that we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before it is too late. We have done lectures in regard to the signs of the day of Qiyamah. And I tell you, most of the signs of the day of Qiyamah have taken place. In regard to the minor signs of the day of Qiyamah, only another few are remaining. And then onwards, the major signs will begin. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, we are headed very rapidly towards the day of Qiyamah. The question you and I need to be asking ourselves, are we ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Malakul Maut is not going to come visit us announced. Today, by the time we reach homes, Malakul Maut may be standing at the doorstep of our homes. By the time we walk to our vehicles, Malakul Maut may be sitting inside our vehicles waiting to take our souls. The question that you and I need to be asking ourselves, are we ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Will we be proud to submit our book of records to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or are we ashamed to even think of our book of records because they are full of sins? Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before it is too late. Turn to Allah in tawbah before Malakul Maut comes to you. Because if Malakul Maut comes and stands in front of you, even if you cry out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at that moment, your tawbah will not be accepted. And turn to Allah in tawbah before the sun rises from the west. The minute the sun rises from the west, the door of tawbah will be slammed shut. And even if we were to cry tears of blood, for no one will the doors of tawbah be opened ever again. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill all of our hearts with taqwa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. And may He accept all of our good deeds. And may He unite us in the gardens of Jannah, just as how He united us here this afternoon with our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.